Analexam. Analexam. No, no, it's a token.
Never mind.
Do you hear me?
Yeah, we hear you.
Look at this compound. See who gets me lost. Please shut down your mic. Shut down your mic. There is a noise. All of you, close, shut down the mic. Look at this compound. What the acid heptulose? How many carbon atoms in this compound?
8.
7.
7. 7.
7. 7. How many hydroxyl group in this compound?
6.
6. Because there is, this is not an hydroxyl group arm. There is 6.
Sorry.
Okay. This is a ketone sugar. It is keto heptose. Please shut down your mic or I'm going to mute your mic. I am going to mute the mic. There is a noise. There is a noise. I'm going to mute the mic. What are isomers? Isomers are molecules which have the same formula. What is meaning of the same formula? The same number of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen atoms. So isomers are molecules or compounds which have the same formula. The same number of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen per molecule, but different in the structural formula. What is the meaning by different in the structural formula? Different in the orientation of hydroxyl group. Is this clear? Do you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
They are molecules which have the same formula, the same number of atoms, but they differ in the structure, in the orientation of the groups, such as the hydroxyl group either to the right or to the left. Asymmetric carbon atoms are carbon atom which has four bonds attached to different groups. Different groups may be chemical group, maybe hydroxyl group, hydrogen, carbonate, sulfate, metal, any group attached to carbon. But the four bonds contain different groups, okay? All monosaccharides have one or more asymmetric carbon atom. Except come in the multiple choice question. Please revise dihydroxyacetone. Dihydroxyacetone does not contain any asymmetric carbon atom.
Okay.
Okay, please look at the formula of dihydroxyacetone. You will find that it does not contain asymmetric carbon atoms. The number of isomers. Stereo means three-dimensional isomers. The number of isomers, 2 to the power of n. What's meaning 2 to the power of n? If I have 2 asymmetric carbon atoms, 2 to the power of 2, we have 4 isomers. If I have 3 asymmetric carbon atoms, 2 to the power of 3 equals what? Please answer. 2 to the power of 3. If I have four carbon atoms, 2^4 equal?
16.
16 isomers. So the number of isomers depend on the number of asymmetric carbon atoms. Aldo, what's meaning by Aldo?
Aldehyde.
What is meaning by triose?
It contains three carbon.
Yes. 3 - 2 = 1. 3 - 2, so I have one asymmetric carbon atom. 2^1 equal 2 isomers. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
What is Aldo?
Aldehyde.
Tetra means four. Okay, 4 - 2, I have 2 asymmetric carbon atoms. Okay? 2^2, I have 4 isomers. Penta, Aldo pentose, 5 - 2 = 3. I have 3 asymmetric carbon atoms. 2^3, I have 8 isomers. Hexa means 6. 6 - 2, I have 4 asymmetric carbon atoms. 2^4, I have 16 isomers. You have to study these numbers. These come in the multiple choice, okay?
Doctor, I have a question on that.
If you look at keto tetros, what's meaning of tetra? Four carbon atom. Ketone. Four minus three equal one. We have one asymmetric carbon atom and 2 isomers. Penta equal 5. 5 - 3 = 2. 2^2, I have 4 isomers. Hexa equal 6. 6 - 3 = 3 asymmetric carbon atom. 2^3, we have 8 isomers. You have to study these numbers, okay? The types of isomers. I have discussed the types of isomer, either optical, anomeric, I will set them, epimer, aldose, ketose, I will discuss them in detail. These are isomers. If you look at D-glucose and L-glucose, what is the difference between D and L?
The different opposition of in the
paper. The carbon atom, which is before the last, is called pen. Pen?
Yes.
Pen?
Pen?
Pen means before the last. This is a Greek letter. Pen means before the last. Ultimate means last. Pen ultimate carbon atom, the carbon before the last. I have hydroxyl group to the right or to the left. This makes a physical property different in the orientation of rotation of light. What is enantiomers? Enantiomers are mirror image. Mirror image means all hydroxyl group are rotated. The hydroxyl group and the second carbon to the right rotated, it becomes to the left. Hydroxyl group to the left, it is rotated, it becomes to the right. And etc. The right, they are rotated, become to the left. So these are mirror image. Okay?
So, but the prop. I have a question.
Yes.
For the post carbon in the that enantiomers, they are not mirror. They are not mirror of each other, because if they were supposed to be in a mirror of each other, definitely this carbon for D glucose, the oxygen must be on the side of hydrogen, and the hydrogen must be on the side of the oxygen. If they are said to be a mirror of each other.
Mm. Hello.
I don't understand the question. I don't understand.
You are talking about now enantiomers, and enantiomer means the mirror of each other. Am I right?
They are mirror of each other. That's why you see the hydroxyl
mirror. They are not mirror.
They are mirror images.
They are not mirror. They are
mirror images. This is the rotation.
They are mirror images. Let me explain to you.
Please, we don't have time because I want to finish.
And then we have L glucose.
Please stop discussion, please. I will call him again. Please stop because we have to finish. If you look at glucose and fructose.
If you,
please stop talking. Please stop talking. If you look at glucose and galactose, please at home count the number of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen atoms. Count the number of carbon atoms, oxygen atom, hydrogen atom in glucose and fructose. You will find the same number. Glucose contains 6 carbon atoms. Fructose contains 6 carbon atoms. Glucose contains 6 molecules of water. Fructose contains 6 molecules of water. They have the same number of atoms, but they are different in the arrangement. If you look, this is a ketone group. This is a keto sugar, but this is aldehyde group. This is an aldo sugar. And this is the difference between glucose and fructose, and this is called aldose hexose isomerism. Okay, please revise them slowly at home, and you will find they contain the same number of atoms, but different in the structure, in the arrangement of atoms, okay? What is anomer? Anomer means the cyclic structure of the sugar. The sugar can make cycle. If you look at carbon number one, it makes a cycle, attached to oxygen, and then oxygen is attached to carbon number five by a bond. Carbon number one makes a cycle with carbon number five. So this is a cycle. There is a cycle between carbon number one and carbon number five. You notice it?
Yes.
You notice the cycle?
Yes,
do you hear me?
No, repeat that one, doctor. Repeat that one.
Okay. This is carbon number one, okay? This is carbon number five.
Yes.
There is a cycle.
Yeah.
I will go from carbon number one. Do you see the yellow color?
Yeah.
Yes.
You see the yellow color? There is a bond between carbon number one and oxygen. Do you notice it? This is an oxygen. Yeah. This is an oxygen. There is a bond between carbon number one and oxygen. There is a bond between carbon number one, the oxygen, and carbon number five. Do you notice it?
Yes.
Carbon number five is attached to carbon number one through all the hydroxyl group in between. Carbon number five is attached to carbon number four. Four is attached to three. Three is attached to carbon number two. Two is attached to one. So there is a cycle. I make a yellow color around the cycle. Yes. Please notice that carbon number one now contains. I don't need any voice. Please stop talking. Stop talking, please. Stop talking. Stop talking, or otherwise I'm going to mute your microphone. Stop talking, please. Look at carbon number one. Carbon number one, there is hydroxyl group. Carbon number one contains hydrogen. You notice it?
Yeah.
Yes. This sugar contains hydroxyl group to the left. At carbon number one, it is thermic beta. This sugar contains hydroxyl group to the right. It is thermic alpha, alpha sugar. But this hydroxyl group is found only in the cycle, in the cyclic structure. Because monosaccharide may be in the cyclic structure or not in the cyclic structure. If it is found dry in the form of a powder, it is not cycle. If the sugar, like glucose, is found dissolved in water in solution, it is found in the form of a cycle. This is a cycle. If you look, this is a cycle. This is a cycle. Okay? Carbon number one, it contains hydroxyl to the right, it is thermic alpha. Carbon number one is thermic anomeric carbon. Anomeric carbon or anomers. If the hydroxyl group to the left, it is beta sugar. Is this clear?
Yeah, getting.
Okay. Please look at glucose, mannose, and galactose. You have seen this figure before. What is the difference between glucose, mannose, and galactose?
In the position of alkanol group.
Hydroxyl group at carbon number 3 to the left. Here is hydroxyl group at carbon number 2 to the left. If you look at this hydroxyl group, at carbon number 3 to the left. In galactose, hydroxyl group at carbon number 3 to the left, at carbon number 4 to the left. So they are called epimers. If you count the number of carbon atoms, the number of hydrogen atoms, the number of oxygen atoms, in glucose, mannose, galactose, they are the same. So they are isomers, and this type of isomers is called epimers. Okay? What is the functions of monosaccharides? Glyceraldehyde, which contain phosphoric acid and dihydroxyacetone. Of course, you have to study the name and memorize them and to know the classification, which carbohydrate belong to which class, because they are divided into classes or groups. Are intermediates, glyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone are intermediates during glucose oxidation. Glucose is oxidized in our body to get energy in metabolism. During glucose oxidation, glyceraldehyde, phosphate, and dihydroxyacetone, phosphate, arise as intermediate molecules in the pathway of glucose oxidation. Erythrose, phosphate, usually sugar is attached to phosphoric acid to become chemically active. This is a form of chemical activation. Erythrose phosphate arise during glucose oxidation in the living cells. Ribose, a component of the RNA, ribonucleic acid. Deoxyribose, a component of the DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. Do you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Hexose, stemmed grape sugar, because they are found in grape. This is the main carbohydrate, we take it in our diet. And every carbohydrates, whatever its type, is converted into glucose inside in our body, because glucose is the main source of energy. Glucose enter in the structure of disaccharide. We will study disaccharide next lecture. And enter in the structure of polysaccharide. We will study polysaccharide next lecture. It is termed dextro. Dextro is a Greek letter, means rotation to the right. Dextrose, because glucose rotates the light to the right side. Okay? Fructose, the fruit sugar. Enter in the structure of honey, fruits, semen. It is found, we will study sucrose next lecture, and we will study inulin next lecture. Sucrose, fructose enter in the structure of sucrose and inulin. Galactose is found in the milk, lactose sugar. Galactose enter in the structure of GAGs. We will study GAGs next lecture. Glycolipid in the lipid course. Glycoproteins in the protein chapter. So galactose enter in the structure of all of these compounds, and all of these compounds have biological function in our body. We are going to study them in detail. Thank you for your attendance.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, anyone has any question can write in the chat box, so I will answer.
Okay, thank you so much.
I have an observation concerning that issue.
Please write your question because the voice is not clear. Write your question, the voice is not clear. Okay, write down your question in the chat box.
Okay, all right.
please, if you have any question, write it on the WhatsApp group and I will answer it. Because I don't find any question now. Please study this lesson, because if you don't study the lessons, the next lecture, you will not understand it. Biochemistry is built upon each other. If you don't understand the first lecture, you will not be able to understand the second or the third lecture, okay?
Okay.
Any question?
Yes? Yes, Prof, I have a question. You said there's, I'm talking about that, as you said in the Shomas, that are the mirrors of each other. So concerning the structure that you have given to us is quite different with the one that I read. That's why I come confused in order, That's why I'm now asking you which one is the correct one. When we said something that I mirror to each other, definitely there's supposed to be a mirror to each other. What I'm talking, the side of that oxygen in the L-glucose and D-glucose, they're supposed to be there and opposite to each other, so that to be in the mirrors, mirror of each other. Because but from your own description, the side, the position of oxygen, they are all in the left hand side. If you take it, it is like this too. I'm become confused. That's why I'm asking you this question.
Because most, this is not important to understand the difference between mirror image enantiomers and between D and L sugars. There is D and L sugar in which the carbon before the last, there is a rotation in the direction of hydroxyl group, the carbon before the last only. But in mirror image, there is a rotation of all carbon and all hydroxyl groups are rotated, okay? But actually, you don't have to know the difference in the chemical or physical properties. You don't have to know the difference actually, because this is not your responsibility. You have to know that this is D and L sugar. D, hydroxyl group to the right of the carbon before the last. L sugar, hydroxyl group to the left in the carbon before the last. But in mirror image, there is a rotation of all carbon atoms. There is a rotation and hydroxyl of all carbon atoms. What is the difference between the two molecules? There are differences only in the physical properties. And it's not your responsibility to know the difference, okay? You have to know the definition of the types of the isomers. What is epimer? What is isomer? The definition only. And you have to study also from your book. You have to buy the book and to study, because there is an explanation in the book more than the PowerPoint. The PowerPoint, it is concise. There is no explanation. Okay? I will make formative assessment after each chapter, and I will put it, I will send it to you. Formative assessment will to revise your knowledge and to make sure that you have studied. This will be in the form of short essay question and multiple choice. Because if there is any point you don't understand or you don't study well, you can again repeat it, okay? If you have any more question, please write it on the WhatsApp group, okay? Thank you very much. I'm going to leave now, okay?
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, I will put the record on the YouTube and I will send to you.
Okay, no problem.
That's okay, goodbye. Bye-bye. Salaamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum as-salam.
Salaam, ma salama.